A few minutes later Carl and Cynthia came hastily across their yard under the huge balm of Galette's. Carl's face was flushed, and his big body quivered with excitement. Cynthia ran behind him, with tears rolling down her face. Thyra felt herself growing sick with fear. Had anything happened to Damaris? A glimpse of the girl sewing by an upper window of the house reassured her. "Oh, Thyra, Thyra!" gasped Cynthia. "Can you stand some good news, Thyra?" asked Carl, in a trembling voice. "Very, very good news?" Thyra looked wildly from one to the other. "There's but one thing you would dare call good news to me," she cried. "Is it about—Chester? Yes, it's about Chester. Thyra, he is alive. He's safe. He and Joe, both of them, thank God. Cynthia, catch her!" "No, I'm not going to faint," said Thyra, steadying herself by Cynthia's shoulder. "My son, alive! How did you hear? How did it happen? Where has he been?" "I heard it down at the harbor, Thyra. Mike MacCready's vessel, the Nora Lee, was just in from the Magdalens. Chess and Joe got capsized the night of the storm, but they hung on to their boat somehow, and at daybreak they were picked up by the Nora Lee, bound for Quebec. But she was damaged by the storm and blown clear out of her course. Had to put into the Magdalens for repairs, and has been there ever since. The cable to the islands was out of order, and no vessels call there this time of year for mails. If it hadn't been an extra open season, the Nora Lee wouldn't have gotten away, but would have had to stay there till spring. You never saw such rejoicing as there was this morning at the harbor, when the Nora Lee came in, flying flags at the masthead." "And Chester, where is he?" demanded Thyra. Carl and Cynthia looked at each other. "Well, Thyra," said the latter, "the fact is, he's over there in our yard this blessed minute. Carl brought him home from the harbor, but I wouldn't let him come over until we had prepared you for it. He's waiting for you there."